This is Music Blocks, a podcast about the building blocks that make up your favorite sounds, whatever you love to listen to. There's only one type of instrument making all of these different sounds. They come from a single voice.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry.
American folk and jazz musician Bobby McFerrin combined 8 tracks of his own vocals for his hit song, Don't Worry, Be Happy. Listen closely. He uses diction to simulate the sounds of percussive instruments and a bass line.
Be happy. Don't worry, be happy now.
He varies the pitch to create vibrato, which produces a stronger, richer tone in the melody.
Be happy. Don't worry, be happy.
Today on Music Blocks, it's all about the power and range of the human voice. Now, technically, the voice is a part of the aerophone instrument family. It makes sound with air, after all. But there's just so much the human voice can do that we decided to give it its own episode. So, get ready to hear how all kinds of vocal techniques, from beatboxing to scatting to yodeling, can create different timbres. A timbre is basically what makes one voice sound distinct from another. We're going to check out how these distinct timbres add meaning to songs. Singing allows musicians to express their ideas and emotions with words.
All of me, why not take all of me?
In the jazz standard All of Me, performed here by American jazz singer Sarah Vaughan, the singer just had her heart broken.
You took the part that once was my heart. So
at one point, Vaughan starts scatting, or singing seemingly nonsensical syllables and phrases. Scat singing can be used to imitate the sound of another instrument, like the trumpet or saxophone. Here, scatting also allows Vaughan to improvise more freely by singing a melody made out of syllables instead of words. Vocalists can add tons of feeling to songs with the way they sing them. Opera singers do this through years of training and practice that helps them sing with precision and power. Just listen to this song from Mozart's opera, The Magic Flute. Sure, the words help tell a story, but the emotional impact comes from the performance. It's intricate, powerful, and virtuosic. There are many singing traditions around the world like this, where the human voice is an instrument that doesn't need words to express meaning. Inuit people from the northern regions of Canada have a distinct singing tradition called throat singing. Traditionally, two women face each other and create music together. One woman sings and the other follows. These performers are Keula and Shaina Novalinga, a mother and daughter. In singing this song, the Novalingas not only connect with each other, but with their ancestors who sang these songs before them. Music is an important part of life for the Baka people who live in Central Africa. They come together to make dynamic and exciting music for all kinds of different occasions, from weddings to preparing for a hunt. This song, recorded in the country of Cameroon, is mostly for passing the time. There's so much cool stuff happening here. The women sing yeyi, basically yodeling. The singers switch between high and low notes super fast. Plus, this music is polyphonic. That means it includes many voices singing distinct melodies. It's also polyrhythmic, which means it incorporates several rhythms simultaneously. All of these individual voices, bringing their own individual timbres, come together to create this vibrant texture. Hip-hop tracks often combine multiple voices. Having those separate timbres on a song makes it feel richer and more varied. Here's a classic example from the 1980s. This song, called The Show, features rappers Dougie Fresh and Slick Rick. It's almost a skit. They rap back and forth about getting ready before a show.
Hey, yo, Doug. What? Put your ballets on.
Yo, Rick, I was about to, but I need the shoe home.
Why?
Because the shoes always hurt my thong.
6 minutes, Dougie Fresh, you're on.
Each rapper has a distinctive timbre to his voice. Slick Rick brings a cool confidence to his lines.
Slick Rick. Well, here's a little something that needs to be heard. Doug, I was going downtown.
Word.
While Dougie Fresh brings energy and precision when he beatboxes. Vocalists use the human voice to bring us all kinds of sounds that enhance the music we listen to. And the timbre of voices add to how we connect with the meaning and emotion in music. This episode of Music Blocks is almost over, so I've got some questions for you. What other types of vocal techniques can you think of? How do they show up in the music you love? When you've thought that through, visit our website for a playlist full of vocal gymnastics. That is at musicblockspodcast.org. For Music Blocks and Colorado Public Radio, I'm Rebekah Romberg.